Good afternoon, students. So today we will do the first unit revision on amplitude modulation. Okay, so what is amplitude modulation? So amplitude modulation, in which the instantaneously the amplitude of the carrier signal will be changing according to the carrier signal, according to the input signal changes. Okay, so the instantaneous value of the amplitude changes with the respect to the carrier. Okay, so we will always send an input and a carrier signal. Here the amplitude will be changing according to the input signal with the help of the carrier signal. So here the amplitude is changing and the remaining phase and frequency are constant. So that is called amplitude modulation. So now we will see the generation of AM wave. So actually there are two methods to generate an AM wave. First one is a square law modulator and switching modulator. It comes to demodulation. What is square law demodulation and envelope detector? What is demodulation? We are sending again after the signal is modulated by the output. Okay, then again we are changing the original changed message signal into an original signal. So that is called demodulation. Okay, so for changing to modulation and demodulation, we have techniques. So in generation of AM waves, square law and switching modulator is there. So square law is not there in your syllabus, so we'll go with the switching modulator. So what does a switching modulator do? We'll see. So this is a block diagram of a switching modulator. Okay, so if you observe, we have a message signal M of T, C of T is a carrier signal and diode, and we have a resistor, and we have here a transformer. Okay, and we have a band pass filter also here, which is tuning at TF. Okay, this is a filter which we are using as a band pass filter, which are tuned as FC. Okay, so what is the basic function of this? Now we will see. So when any input has sent as a sign signal, when you are sending an input signal, okay, so here this is a consider a semiconductor diode. This is a semiconductor diode used as an ideal switch to which a carrier C of T is on message M of T. Okay, and simultaneously they have applied. So we are giving a diode of a semiconductor and we are having a carrier signal and we are having a message signal. These two we are giving to a diode. Now it is assumed that the C of T is applied to diode is in large amplitude. If we are assuming it, then if it is having a large amplitude, what will be the voltage, what will be the message signal, we will see. Okay, so we are assuming that C of T applied to the diode is in large amplitude. So what happens at that case? So here if you consider this V1 of T is equal to M of T plus C of T, message plus carrier. Okay, now V1 of T is equal to M of T plus AC cos 2 pi FC of T. This we know, the carrier signal function, it is AC cos 2 pi FC of T, where M of T, mod of M of T is always less than the carrier. Okay, then only we can do a modulation. Okay, now the output of the device is V2 of T is equal to V1 of T. When carrier signal is greater than 0, we will get V1 of T. When it is less than 0, we will not get any. So always the carrier should be high. Okay, according to the message signal, then only we can send the carrier and message signal to the output side and do modulation. Okay, so we have small derivation regarding this. So here this is a pulse train. Okay, periodic train pulses. Okay, for every train pulse at t naught by 4, and we are representing this as g t naught. If you see this, we can represent as G T naught of T, where G is the periodic train pulses for 1 minute period of time. Okay. Now if you see T naught is equal to 1 by FC. FC is the centered frequency where the bandwidth, whatever we are seeing as a center frequency, we are representing as FC. Now mathematically the output of diode can be written as V2 of t is equal to V1 of t into Gp of t. Okay, where Gp is a rectangular pulse train with periodic equal to the T naught is equal to 1 by FC. Okay, so representing Gp of t by using its Fourier transform. Okay, when you apply a Fourier transform to that, what you get. So if you see, first I am saying V2 of t is equal to V1 of t Gp of t, and V1 of t plus low, yeah, I am writing m of t plus ac cos 2 pi fc of t into gp of t. See, this is a equation 1 which we got before. Okay, now gp of t is a rectangular pulse. Now we need to consider the gp of t in the Fourier transform. So this is the Fourier transform gp of t. Representing this gp of t by its Fourier transform, we have this formula. Gp of t is equal to 1 by 2 2 by pi n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 n minus 1 to n minus 1 cos 2 pi fc n minus 1 whole t. So this is a Fourier transform. If you have a SS, the related formulas are this. Okay, now we need to add this n is equal to 1, see, 1 by 2 2 pi pi cos 2 pi fc of t, plus we need to add the harmonic components, odd harmonic components. Okay, why this harmonic components are used for generating the more number of signal. Okay, so this is a signal when n is equal to 1. When n is equal to 1, this is a signal. Now we know that cos, so now this is, we are calling this equation as 4, and now you substitute the equation 4 in 3. Where is the 3 equation? This is the 3 equation. Okay, that is nothing but just you have to represent V2 of t. This is same, just a Gp value. I am just adding in this. I am just writing that Gp value in the next before of V1 of 2. Okay, now we need to little bit do problem. So 1 by 2 m of t, 1 by 2 m of t plus 2m of t plus 5 cos 2 pi fc of t plus ac by 2. This is ac by 2 cos 2 pi fc. Every term I am multiplying with this. Okay. Plus 2ac cos square 2 pi fc of t. It's nothing but this and this. Okay. So once you observe the equation, you will understand again. 1 by 2 m of t plus 2 m of t into cos 2 pi m of t plus ac by 2 cos 2 pi fc of t plus 2 ac pi cos square 2 pi fc pi, like this we can show on. So now we know that cos square theta is equal to 1 by 2 plus cos 2 theta by 2. This is a trigonometry formula we all know. Now we need to substitute this value here, cos square theta. Okay, this value in cos square theta. So write the same whole, the same thing as till here it is same. Okay, ac by 2 cos square. Now here I am writing in place of cos square theta 1 by 2. Okay, that is nothing but ac by 2 ac by 2 t plus 2 ac cos theta by 2. Compare that equation with that, you will understand. Now m of t by 2 plus 2 m of t by pi cos 2 pi fc of t plus ac cos 2 pi fc of t plus 2 to cancel, ac by pi plus ac cos 4 pi fc of this, 2 cancel. Okay, this is the fifth equation. Now the output of the band pass filter is v dash of t, that is the output what we are getting at the filter side. From this equation only we are taking out the 2 pi pi of t m of t cos 2 pi fc of t plus, so same thing we are writing, okay. And from this, if you see the equation properly, 2 by ac by 2, ac by 2 cos 2 pi fc of t, this one, plus 1 plus 2 into 2, what is this 2, n is equal to 2, for 2, okay, for n is equal to 2, what will be the equation? So that is nothing but 1 plus 2 by 2 into pi ac into m of t. Next, the same thing, 2 by 2 and 4, 2 into 2, 4 m of t, okay. So now this equation we are representing as Ka. What is this Ka? Amplitude sensitivity. So when you apply this Ka in this equation, you get like this, just Ka represent of m of t, okay. So this is a V of 2, this is the output of the band pass filter, okay. Again, once you check the video, if you have any doubt, please ping me, okay. So this is the equation for generation of AM wave in switching modulator, okay, in switching modulator. So when they ask generation of AM wave using switching modulator, you need to know. So if you see the expected graph also, when slope is equal to 1, the graph is going on increasing from 0 to 5. So that we are seeing that the amplitude is instantaneously varying with the carrier and the input signal. That's what we want in amplitude modulation, okay. Now coming to the demodulation of AM wave. So there are two methods. In this also the square law demodulator is not there in your syllabus. We'll talk about envelope detector. Okay, so when you see the notes, don't blindly see the notes whatever I gave. So because some of the topics are removed, some are added. Okay, so see the topic, see this, keep the syllabus book beside you and do it. Okay. So envelope detector. So what is the envelope detector? So envelope detector, we are using demodulation of the So this is a demodulation of the AM wave, which we are calling as an envelope detector. So we have a circuit diagram. It is simple and highly effective device which we are using for demodulated AM wave. Demodulator is nothing but after modulation we are going to convert the modulating signal into an original signal, okay. So it consists of a diode and a resistor and a capacitor, okay, and we have a RC filter, okay. So here what is the operation? Same, the operation is like half way rectifier, full way rectifier, okay. In a single diode half wave rectifier EDC, if you go through, when the one positive wave is going on, the other will be forward and the other will be reversed. Say the same process here. So what happens here is that during the positive half of the cycle of the input signal, okay, we have an input signal suppose like this. So when we are having a positive signal, okay, when during the positive half signal of the input signal, the diode will be in forward bias, okay. And when it is in forward bias, the capacitor charges at peak value of input, the peak value of the input it charges, okay. when input falls down below the level, so maximum it can somewhere it will stop. Okay, after that again it has to fall down to some point. Okay, so when input falls below this value, diode become reverse. Okay, when the waveform from the positive to from down it is falling to negative, the diode becomes reverse bias. When it becomes reverse bias, this will get discharged slowly through the load resistor. To the load resistor it will slowly discharges. Okay, as a result only positive half cycle of the AM well appears at RL, means it will not give a negative, only positive cycles it will generate. Okay, but when we have two diodes, two both are possible, but here we are doing with only one diode, so this is the operation. Now the discharging process continues. Which is discharging this capacitor? Discharged process continues until next positive half cycle will occur. When the input signal becomes greater than the voltage, okay, across the capacitor, the diode conducts again and process is repeated. So always we have to see the input signal should always be greater than the voltage, then only we can generate only positive half cycles with maximum amplitude. Okay, so selection of RC time constant, so this is very important here. So the capacitor charges through D, okay, and RS, and when D is on it discharges. Okay, when D is down and it discharges through RL when D is off. Okay, so charging time constant RS of T, this is the nothing but the charging time constant. RSC should be short as compared to the carrier period 1 by FC. Then only we can see a positive signals properly. RS of C is less than 1 by FC, but FC is a centered frequency. Okay, and RS is a resistor. The load, how much you are getting, okay, this is SRS, okay, this is RL. So RSC should always be less than the center frequency FC. So if you see, so why it is called envelope detector? See, here it is the input signal we are giving here, okay, but if you see the output, it is showing a positive wave. Okay, so some of the waves we get envelope in the sense it overlap with each other and that wave will not be considered. Okay, so on the other hand, discharging time constant RLC should be long enough to ensure that C discharges slowly.